Hey everyone, Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode, Web3. You've heard so much about Web3 and, you know, is it the future of everything or is it just a fad? So in this little video, I'll give you my take on it and give you some of the background and explain to you what we're working on at Xandeum here, building a scalable storage layer for the Solana chain. And with Web3, you know, there are some Web3 apps out there, right? And it was a big, big marketing hype like 1 or 2 years ago. And we had even Elon Musk tweeting about it and saying, well, it's mostly a marketing gag, but it isn't there yet, right? And then we heard a little bit less about Web3 over time. And fact of the matter is, there is some base technology that is needed for Web3, but it's missing today. You know, there is no scalable storage layer for smart contracts out there in the world. So let that sink in. There is no scalable storage layer for smart contracts, right? And so many people have heard about storage in blockchain, right? Most of this is storing files standalone without, you know, without being natively built in the smart contract world. So what does that mean, right? I mean, Web3 needs smart contracts. Web3 is code. We all understand that. Web2 is code that runs on servers, on just normal centralized servers. Web3 is code that runs on the blockchain, right? The blockchain being kind of a world computer, right? Consisting of many servers that all control and supervise each other and have some sort of consensus mechanism. So it's all about the code, it's all about the smart contracts, and the smart contracts need to have access to scalable storage. So on current smart contract chains, we have accounts, right? So Solana has these Solana accounts, Ethereum has their Ethereum accounts, and you know, EVM chains have all their accounts. These accounts are great, but they don't scale with regards to storage capacity. You cannot store even a gigabyte on there unless you have a few billions of dollars to pay for it. You cannot store terabytes there, right? So if we want to make Web3 happen, and if we even want to port today's Web2 apps, popular Web2 apps, to Web3, let's say we want to have a Web3 version of X. We want to have a Web3 version of Airbnb. Why do we want to have these Web3 versions? Well, it's all about decentralization, right? And it means decentralization of control. I'm not talking about decentralization like geographically. There are so many fake Web3 projects out there, right? That are just centralized businesses. They give a token and then they claim they are like blockchain, right? Which they're not. I mean, the only thing is they pay you in a token, but otherwise the business is centralized. And yeah. So with real Web3, it is awesome. The world wants decentralization. It's not for everything, right? There are so many things where we don't need decentralization. We can do it in a centralized manner. Centralization has advantages. For consumers, so many, they want to have someone they can turn to in case something doesn't happen. And, you know, there is one centralized instance that is responsible and that can give you support and things like that, right? But it is also undeniable that the world has a hunger for decentralized systems for many applications, not for all, but for many. And that's the reason we have trillions of dollars of market capitalization in all those different coins, crypto coins out there, right? If there was no demand for decentralization, it would be zero. It would not be trillions, right? So that's all because the world needs decentralization. There's many reasons for that, why there is that demand for decentralization. And there is demand for running code in a decentralized way. That's why we have all these smart contract chains. There are so many out there. Layer ones, layer twos, all of them are there. We want that. But we want them to be a real world computer, right? We want them to have a scalable storage layer so that we can, for example, build a Web3 version of Wikipedia, right? Wikipedia today is centralized, right? So there is a, you know, anyone can make changes and it's being logged to the database, but it's a centralized company. So if you make a change there and, you know, Jimmy Wales, the owner of Wikipedia, he could just delete it in the history, right? So that it seems like you never made that change or never even suggested that change, right? That's a problem, right? And also there's many problems with content moderation and stuff like that. That could all be decentralized. And there are so many problems with, you know, centralized systems, and they can all go decentralized if we have a blockchain, a smart contract blockchain with a scalable storage layer, right? And I need to make clear here that this is fundamentally different from some of these storage chains that are out there, right? There is Filecoin out there, for example, right? But this is not a storage layer for smart contracts. It is not inherently an enabler for Web3. You could connect it to smart contracts somehow, but it's a real hassle, and then it's not performant, and it's, you know, really, really unwieldy for the developer. It's a completely different paradigm, and that's the reason, you know, we can't build Web3 versions of Wikipedia, of Airbnb, of X, of eBay, or stuff like that, right? And that's the first step. That's the first step for Web3. We want to bring the Web2 apps that we all know and love, we want to decentralize them, bring them to Web3. And then there will be lots of Web3 apps that are not even possible on Web2 and that nobody really can imagine these days, right? And that is the reason why we are building the Xandeum scalable storage layer. There's a strong, strong reason why we do that. A strong, strong problem these days, because Web3 just isn't possible because there is no scalable storage layer nowhere, right? And I couldn't be more excited to work on this problem. Those are hard, hard, tough problems that we're working on. I'm happy we have that great, great team that's super motivated and super competent to work on that. And I cannot wait until we have that. We will be launching our PNodes, the storage provider nodes, soon. So those are the nodes that are being supervised by the validator nodes. They store the actual data. There will also be access provider nodes that cache these data and make it available fast and queryable to application developers or even to users just as you. And so this might have been the missing piece that you might have been missing on Web3, right? It's a little bit like, you know, why aren't there so many Web3 apps, successful Web3 apps, as we have Web2 apps? Just because that missing piece of technology. And I like to compare that to the times, you know, when I was in university many decades ago. I was interested back in the 80s in artificial intelligence. I was super interested in the field, and everyone was excited about it. Everyone felt like this is going to be the future. Artificial intelligence is going to change the world. But back in the 80s, we didn't know how, right? I was working with a programming language called Prolog. So what we built is what's called expert systems. And it's all in code, and it's like with rules and if then else and stuff like that. And that led us nowhere, right? So all over the 90s and late 80s, AI was dead. It was simply because there was a missing piece in the base technology, and that came in the late 90s and then in the 2000s and the 2010s and 20s, it all went crazy. And that base technology for AI is called ANNs, artificial neural networks. So we tried to mimic, well, we didn't only try to mimic, we mimicked the neural networks that are found in the brains of mammals and supposedly also, you know, insects and stuff like that. They all have neural networks, right? Your fly that's, you know, flying around in your room, it couldn't recognize, you know, where's a wall. I don't want to, you know, it doesn't want to fly against the wall, right? That mosquito needs to recognize, well, what's a human or another animal where I can, you know, suck my blood out, right? So and it needs neural networks for that, right? So even in these lower level animals, we have neural networks in nature, and when we mimicked that in software, it ignited an explosion, a Cambrian explosion in all different styles of AI, right? And, you know, that would be worth a whole series of videos, like the history of AI in the past, like, 50 years or so. And that is very interesting. But when that missing piece of base technology, artificial neural networks, came into being, that was the start of everything for artificial intelligence. And now think about having that missing piece of technology, which is a scalable storage layer. It's simply what's needed to make Web3 possible, right? Think about when that happens, when we have that scalable storage layer for smart contracts, right? I'm not talking about any storage blockchain. They don't provide that scalable storage layer for smart contracts, and that's what we need to get Web3 going, right? And once we have that underlying base technology, think about that explosion of apps that can come to life out of that. And I find that super, super exciting, and that's why I'm working on that scalable storage layer. I founded Xandeum. If you haven't heard of Xandeum, link is in the description, xandeum.com. If you go to our website, top right corner on our website, you find all the sign-up links. So you can sign up for our Discord. I encourage you to sign up for our Discord server because it's a very interactive medium. And you can chat with us. Our team is there. I'm there often. Also sign up for our email list because everything that's coming out, for example, the PNode providers, the incentivized DevNet, and there are so many things that are being launched in the next few weeks and months. And stay up to date by signing up for that email list. And also subscribe to this channel. Smash that like button. By the way, we have a points program as well on xandeum.com. So liking this video, subscribing to my channel, etc., it all gives you points. And for today, thanks so much for watching, guys. Catch you later. Peace.